The year was 6150 BC, and in what is now the United Kingdom, a prominent human culture lived across much of the island, primarily near the coastline. At the time, the sea level was 15 meters or 49 feet below modern levels, and the coastline in some areas was more than 100 kilometers towards the ocean when compared to its current location. The British Isles were still connected to mainland France, although this would not last for long. Then, the unthinkable happened. A massive wall of water crashed into the coastline, but it did not stop there. It was so large that it continued to advance over the low-lying areas, continuing onwards for many minutes. Soon, this massive tsunami had reached 80 kilometers inland, wiping out potentially hundreds to thousands of indigenous peoples who lived in small communities. As the water finally receded, it left behind a thick white layer in the landscape, which would later be buried in the black layer of peat. What had just occurred was the region's largest tsunami in the last 10,000 years. It did not occur due to a large magnitude earthquake, but rather one of the planet's most voluminous submarine landslides. Known as the Storegga Slide, this event was caused by the collapse of 3,200 cubic kilometers of glacial sediment in sections of Norway's continental shelf. Although this event might seem too large to have occurred more than once, it is not an isolated event. Recent evidence suggests that over the last 500,000 years, a similarly large landslide occurred about once every 100,000 years. This means that a deadly repeat of this event is almost certain to occur at some point in the future. To understand exactly why this catastrophic landslide occurred, we must first understand what the planet was like during the last glacial period of the Ice Age. 20,000 years ago, the planet was almost uniformly 7.8 degrees Celsius or 14 degrees Fahrenheit colder than it is today, meaning that ancient London had a climate near identical to modern-day Reykjavik and Iceland. The modern two-thirds of the isles were covered in thick glaciers, and much of the modern North Sea was also covered in ice. Over many thousands of years, ice streams which advanced across the landscape carried with them large volumes of rock fragments and sediments from the rocks they carved into. Much of this material was deposited in what is called a terminal moraine at the site of the modern North Sea fan. As glacial periods waxed and waned, hundreds of meters thick of sediment built up on the steep continental edge. Eventually, this weight reached a critical point, causing a massive landslide to begin. As the landslide occurred, it soon propagated to other areas along the continental shelf, propagating to a 180-mile or 290-kilometer-long section of ground. Soon, 3,200 cubic kilometers of material rapidly traveled beneath the ocean's surface, where large boulders of material would go on to travel as much as 800 kilometers distant. This landslide displaced a significant quantity of water, leading to the generation of a towering tsunami. Several large waves propagated outwards from the slide, although the distribution of heights was not exactly even. Along the Norwegian coastline closest to the slide's origin, waves between 12 and 14 meters inundated large swaths of the coastline. In the Shetland Islands, the tallest waves are observed, towering to a height of more than 25 meters. In the Faroe Islands, waves of 14 meters were observed. The waves would go on to strike Iceland, all of the British Isles, the Netherlands, Greenland, and beyond, with wave heights of between 2 and 19 meters. Although the exact human toll of this ancient event is unclear, it was likely quite high. Some sources claim that two other voluminous landslides occurred, which were more than an order of magnitude smaller in the following 100 years, but I was unable to verify this assertion. All I could find were further reports that a small tsunami in 3500 BC, which struck the British Isles, may have also originated from a further collapse of the Storegga Slide area. Luckily, a similarly large-scale repeat of the tsunami is unlikely to occur until the end of the next glacial period, meaning that for now, the chance of a repeat event is incredibly low. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron, Kimberly Orr, for supporting this channel.